everyone. First of all, sorry if I'm a bit like tired or I look like bored or something. It's actually 4 a.m. So yeah, I just thought it was the best time to actually film a YouTube video. Today we are going to make FXs. So I'm not a pro on FXs or something. I just like to do it and I just wanted to share my process on how I do FXs in my webtoon. Talking about process, this year there will be a new process video because I've learned a lot of new things, especially right after my last video about how to color your webtoon, but I'm gonna show you that in other videos. So I think like every year I will make an update on process video. Anyway, today we are here to add a new video in my playlist, Webtoon Starter Pack, which has only one video for now, which is the asset video. And I really recommend this video. So I will make tiny videos about how to start your webtoon journey or your comic journey and to be as fast as you can. So unfortunately for this video, I will not be able to show you more than what you have on the screen right now. I just choose some illustrations, two panels from my webtoon, and one page I save for the next video, which will be about the auto actions. But so you only will be able to see these two panels right here because I'm working on the original version of The Wonder Witch. So of course I can't spoil you, like I cannot. But anyway, you will still be able to see these two panels right here. I most likely took them as an example. So first we have a first FX, which is really simple because the panel is really important and I wanted it to be really clear. So what I mean by that is that, for example, this panel right here is a bit more decorated, a bit more filled with informations. So I wanted the FX to be a bit more decorated as well. And you have the most simple FXs, which are cute but emphasizing the text. As you can see, I like to make tiny FX sometimes just to match, but I'm not every time doing the shadows. I just like to play around with FXs. So this was for the examples. I just can't show you more, but we will make some FXs in this video, so you will be able to see some ways to make them. And of course I will show you how to save it either on a page that you can save for later as a clip file or into the material category, which you have on the side of your screen right here. And just, you know, be faster. Again, the goal in the webtoon projection is to be fast. So we'll start with the night ones. First, depends of if you want to save them for later or not. We will either make them into the panel right away here, or you will create a new file here. So let's make a square pretty big just to use it and be a— oh wow. I'm sorry, wait, let me just a bit adjust the luminosity. So we will be able to resize it if we need the effects. I will work on this blank canvas here, but I will just display the panel here. So just to have the perfect mood, the perfect colors, etc. Just to save it later. But you can totally make your FXs on the panel right away. If you're like me, you will probably do this because I personally like to do FXs, but I don't save them, even if I think this is really a good way to save time. But as you saw previously, I just like to do a lot of different types of FXs. I just like to play with it. Depends of the mood and the panel. So I personally don't save it, okay? But I really do recommend doing this just to save time. So what are we going to make? I don't know. Okay, so first I'm going to create a folder. So depends again of if you want to save them as a picture or as a material. This is two different things that I explained pretty well in my last video about the CSP assets. So there are two different ways to save your material or your FX. I mean, three technically if you want to save it. So you can either save the whole page as a clip file, you know, as an illustration, but you can open anytime you need. Or you can click on edit, save the material, and you can choose picture or model. Okay, this is our FX. I have my folder here, so edit, save the material, picture, call your FX like the name you want, So we saved it as a picture, and we will save it as a material just to see the difference. So to save it as a material, you just select your folder here and also select your FX. The difference between selecting or not the FX is this. So if you don't select the FX and you save it as a model, like as a material, it will save the whole canvas. So you have to select it first, and so you have to click on edit. Cut. Of course, I'm cutting the FX here, like I'm cutting the canvas here because I didn't make the FX really big in the canvas, but just make your canvas really big if needed, like this. But let's just cut it to show you. So if I cut it here, the material will be the good size. And there's also the fact that you can save your FX as a picture, but like a flat picture. So if you want to make your FXs as brushes, you cannot just save it as a picture like alone, because the brush tip option here is not able to recognize layers. So what I'm going to do for that is that I'm selecting the folder here, I go on layer and just merge the layer, like the selected layers here, and I have only one layer. Then you go on edit, save the material, picture. So now that we have our FXs here, you can either drag the big one, so it will be only one layer appearing here, or you can drag the folder material, which is here. Now, as you can see, instead of having just one layer, you have a whole folder that you can totally edit, so you can still change the color of your FXs. I know that in my last video I said that picture materials were always flat, but this will only because I actually merged the layers together, but it was also because I saved it as a brush tip. So let's make our FXs now. So I'm just gonna sketch a little bit of the FX I want. So let's make something like this. And maybe like a tiny to write something for your sound effect. You can either use a font you have in your computer. Of course, try to take free fonts, but you can also draw it by hand. Sometimes I do it. I just use my own pencil and just like this, like Let's just use it this way. So this is my sketch. I'm gonna go with this idea. So I'm just gonna cut it. So let's put them aside. Let's call that the So what we will do here is to use the landmark layer, just for the FX not to be pixelized when you use it. So I'm just gonna do something plain black to start. I will make the tiny. Okay, so now let's decorate it. Create a gradient. Again, we'll stay simple. Just take the same colors as your background maybe, and just make the color maybe a little bit brighter, just to separate the FX from the panel. So I'm just gonna put my panel behind my FX. Let's try with something maybe more muted. And now let's add a contour. I really like to use contour if the panels are too dark, because it's really enhancing the FX. Again, it's just about searching and finding what's good for your panel. Yeah, I think it's good. So let's just get rid of the panel. And if you want to get a bit fancier, you can still duplicate your FX folder, merge it, then lock the transparent pixels, fill it, and just put it right under your FX. And maybe you can, you know, just move it a little bit and you have kind of like a shadow. Sometimes I'll also make it white or black. And as you can see, I applied a contour on the FX folder. So everything that is inside this folder will have this contour. So now that we have our first FX, let's save it. Now that we have saved it, just, you know, take your panel, drag and drop from here, and ta-da, you can use it. Since it's from a vector layer, it will not get pixelized or anything. I just think it works kind of cute here. What's good when you are saving your FX this way is that you can totally change the contour thickness. Here it's a bit too thick to me, so I'm just gonna make it thinner. Now you can use your FX everywhere you want. So let's just duplicate the folder here, and ta-da, we change the colors. Okay, let's try different colors on different panels, just to see how many things you can get from only one FX. Yeah, I really do think that it's better here, because it's like where she is looking at. You know, the FX is better, works better if it's around the place where the action takes place. Yeah, sorry, this was a mistake of mine, so... So, let's make another one. For the rain, I think something like sha or I don't know will work kind of well. So let's take our phones. So here I'm using the phones for you to know how to use it. I mean, not the phones, but how to create an FX from there. So I have plans for this tiny text. So I'm not gonna stay with the text layer. Let's merge it here. So I'm just gonna convert the layer now as a vector layer. So I'm just choosing some options to make it look good. And ta-da, I have a line work layer, so maybe just fix it a little bit. What I'm going to do for this one is that I'm going to separate all the letters first. Let's just select the text but without the first letter, cut it here. It's gonna create another layer without the rest of the text, and do this for all of your letters here. So we have our letters. Maybe let me take the panel first. Again, just to have a better view of what I'm doing. Let's now place our letters. So I will put a tiny contour on every letters. Okay, 22, 22, 22, and 22. Now we have all our letters. You can totally lay it like this, but what I like to do is add a gradient. You can either lay it like this, which is kind of cute, but I'm gonna add a tiny effect on the layer for the gradient to not take in consideration the contour. But I think that it would work better if I had gradients on each letters separately, just to change the height of the gradients. So let me show you what I mean by that. Here I'm just gonna add this one, put it, let me be, yeah. I'm gonna duplicate this one, put it on the edge. Here you can see the difference. It's really way more dynamic like this, but I will not just make it this way. It's a bit, you know, it's a bit empty. You can add a contour on the wall FX, which always work for FXs. And here you already have a really different FX than the first one. So I'm gonna keep this version, but I have another idea. Let's just get rid of all the gradients. I have my folder here, match the folder, and I'm just gonna go on edit and converts luminance to opacity, and it will get rid of all the white. So the converting luminance to opacity is a thing that will convert all your colors in black and white, and the more your colors are light, the more the convert luminance to opacity will make it transparent. So the black will be really opaque, and the more it's white, the more the luminance to convert to opacity will make it transparent. So to make it glowy, let's first make it white and then duplicate the layer. Now we are going to color it, so let's put it red for now, but we can change the color after, don't worry, it's just for me to see it better. So here you can either blur it now, or what I personally like to do is to add a contour the same color as our layer here. Now I'm going to create another layer and merge this new layer to the one at the bottom, because if you keep the contour here as an option and not merge the new layer here, and when you want to have a blur, it will be really bad looking when you get closer here. We don't want that. So again, create a new layer on top of it and merge it, just to create a new pixelized layer without a contour. Now we are going on filter, blur, and Gaussian blur. Blurry, ta-da! First, you can keep it like this, or you can even do another option. And so with this, you can totally click here, go on select from the layer, create a selected zone, delete the white layer, and you're gonna erase what's inside the selecting zone. And ta-da, you have a transparent neon. You can change the color, but you can also play with the white opacity. So I'm just gonna select the white layer, get rid of what's in the selection era on the neon layer. And now you can play with the white opacity, or even make it black. It can be really fun. So it's not really a neon anymore, but it's more like a glowy thing. You can even make it transparent, but with a gradient. So it could be transparent, but only on the top part. And you can even can make your gradient two colors. Ta-da! It's really, really cute and nice. Okay, now let's use it on our panel. I really recommend to make your FXs big because you will need it to be resized. Yeah, it works better. Oh, I like it. Yeah, okay, good. Okay, let's give that one. Okay, guys, it sounds good for this video. I think we have enough, you know, informations here, like for you to be able to create your own FXs. You will have a pack more filled. The links will be in the descriptions, but you will be able to find the pack on my online shop and on Acon 30. So just, you know, feel free to check it out. Anyway, this is a wrap for this video, finally. I just hope it will be helpful. As always, if you have any other idea for a video, comment and share and like the video. I really appreciate the support. We are already more than 1,000 people on this channel, so thank you so much. I really appreciate it because I really work hard on my YouTube videos. I wish I could work more, like, you know, put more videos on my channels, but it's a bit hard with the work. Anyway, so thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.